Let's start with you, Andrew. Tell us about the photographs. Are they just of this one historically black college, or are they of a variety of them?
No, so this is a portrait. There is a book with 60 photographs. The exhibition has 25 of those photographs, and it is all of the relatively quiet campus of Morris Brown College. And in the decades after the Civil War, there were about 120 colleges established to educate African Americans. There were down to about 100 of those colleges, but those 100 colleges are 3% of colleges in America, yet they represent more than 10% of African Americans who go to college and more than 25% of African Americans who earn degrees. And so while this is a portrait of empty educational spaces, it makes the point that these historically black colleges remain an essential on-ramp to the American middle class.
Wow.
And Mr. Hooker, we definitely want to bring you into this. Part of this story, part of this event, of course, is being told through music. Let's talk about the role of music in this. Why was it so important?
Well, to begin with, the initiation for me writing this piece was actually an invitation from Andrew to reflect through my musical art the themes that he was trying to convey in his photographic work. And of course, music has been at the heart of African American culture and heritage for years, even when we were slaves. But the historically black colleges and universities kind of embodied that even more so. And what I tried to do with my composition is to reflect the historical origins of historically black colleges and universities, the times in which they arose, the struggles that they helped us as a people get through, and the uncertainty of where their future is going, but the very critical necessity that they still have in the life, not only of African Americans, but in the nation as a whole.
Yeah, let's talk about that a little bit. I'd love for each of you, Mr. Hooker, you first, perhaps, to answer those who might say, well, you know, colleges don't discriminate any longer, so why don't we just all go to whatever college we want? Why is it important to keep the HCBUs vitally, strong? Why is it still important in today's world?
It's critically important because, as we know, so often in the transition from being a teenager to a young adult is where identity gets confirmed and formed. And for so many young African Americans, the uncertainty of what they are in the larger cultural context is a source of stress and anxiety. And historically black colleges is an experience of reinforcing their value, their sense of identity, their sense of worth, while also educating them, helps to strengthen them and give them a strong foundation for the future. And that's something mainstream colleges can't do as a whole. So they still have extremely important role in the life and culture, again, not only of African Americans, of this nation as a whole.
Your thoughts on the role of historically black colleges and university in the 21st century?
Well, I think that what's important here is that people are voting with their feet. And as long as we have the kind of attendance that we have at historically black colleges, then the folks that choose to go to these colleges are making a statement that this is a right fit for them. And we have to welcome diverse on-ramps to the American middle class. And we have a huge issue in our society of how do we provide opportunity in America. And this is an important avenue for providing opportunity in America.
Very, very good. Right. The photographs are beautiful. We know the music will be as well. Thank you so much for taking some time with us this morning.
We do appreciate it. Thank you.